It's the National Football League on EA Sports.
The punter Jack Fox to get this one started. And off we go from Dallas. Here's Kevontae Turpin on the return. And this drive will start inside the 25. So here come the Cowboys for their opening drive. Bringing him out, coming off one of his best seasons as a pro, an MVP runner-up finish in year number 9, Dak Prescott.
Were not for some guy named Lamar Jackson up there in Baltimore, I think Dak Prescott would have won MVP last year. Had his best season statistically. Total control of that Cowboy offense. Over 4,500 yards. And remember, he led in touchdown passes with 36. But we know what it's all about in Dallas. It's not what you do in the beginning. It's how it finishes. And can you take those steps in the playoffs?
And he stopped after a nice gain up past the 25. He gets a half dozen on the carry. That's also going to bring up 3rd and 6.
Brings up 3rd and 6.
Working out of the gun, it's Prescott. That's caught for the first. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. Big play gets him across midfield, sets him up 1st and 10 from the 40. First down, here's Dak. This one caught by C.D. Lamb. And he'll go out of bounds close to the 35-yard line. Halfway to the marker, it's 2nd and 5. From the 36. Nice work by the back here, playing safety valve, complete. Takes out a one stop. And he's brought down at the 17-yard line. Play goes for 19 and a new set of downs. They'll come up 1st and 10.
Cowboys. 1st and 10 at the 17-yard line.
Another throw for Prescott. That one's incomplete in the end zone.
I'm just going to say, maybe not the guy you want to pick on in coverage in this particular series. Gets a hand on that throw and knocks it away. The next time, well, he could get two hands on it and take it the other way.
So after the incompletion, here comes the 2nd down call. They run it from the gun with Elliott. And he stopped out at the 16 after a small gain. Only a yard from that time, so now 3rd and 9. He gets it out left, and it's caught. And he will score. Touchdown, Dallas. The Cowboys. Series. C.D. Lamb with the touchdown. That one splits the uprights. And they add one on to their first touchdown of the contest. Aubrey now to kick this one away. Greg Reynolds to return it. And this will give them decent field position. The return gets out to the 30. So the Lions take the field for their first drive. And leading them out in his ninth NFL season, he experienced a real resurgence last year. It's Jared Goff.
Okay, there are other flashier quarterbacks that make more highlight reel plays than Jared Goff. There certainly are bigger and stronger athletes playing the position today, but Jared's just a throwback, a guy that understands the timing and the precision. I love that he knows what he is and what he isn't when it comes to his skills, and it's why he's been able to flourish in multiple places and why he continues to sustain a lot of success in this league.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Staying on the ground with Montgomery. And he'll take it past the midfield stripe and start the push into Cowboys territory. Give him 9 yards. He almost moved the chains there. It's going to be second and one. They'll run again with Montgomery. And that short gain is enough for a new set of downs.
Hey, Kate, you want to see a picture in the football dictionary of staying on schedule? That was it.
Going to the ground again on first. And he's tackled after gaining a handful. Minute and six on the play, bringing up second and four. Shotgun snap here to Goff. Escapes out to the left. Oh, look at this. Here he goes. It's a pickup of 11. And that'll be first down, Detroit. Montgomery gets it from the gun. And he runs this one down to the 22-yard line. Good rip on first down. That brings up second and two. From the gun, gone. Got Williams, and it's complete. And they have this down to the 11 before being marked down. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And that gives the Lions the first. A toss play, Montgomery. And he almost gets to the 5. He goes out at the 6. First down play, nets him 5. It's going to be second and 5. Out of the shotgun, Goff. And what a risk, but he can't hang on. No interception, but nearly a turnover in the end zone.
Oh, that was such an opportunity lost. They were looking for a way out without giving up any points on the series. And instead, well, he just couldn't quite hang on.
Goff now on third down. Getting out to his left. And they will score. Touchdown, Detroit. The Lions finish off their opening drive. It's a Jared Goff touchdown. That one right down the middle. And we're all knotted up. Fox now to kick this one away. Returning it from the 4. The return. Just beyond the 30. Back out come the Cowboys for their second drive. And after the impressive drive we just witnessed, you gotta imagine that they are hoping to respond with something similar.
Yeah, and I don't love to use the word can't, right? But this can't be a 3-and-out for this offense right here. They gotta give their defense a chance to catch their breath and turn some of the momentum in the building.
Into a ton of traffic, and this one's intercepted. Terry on Arnold has it. And the Lions are hauled down on the return at the 45-yard line.
I don't know what to be impressed by most, Brock. How effortless he made it look to throw it that deep, or how effortless the cover man made it look to get that far down there and haul in the interception.
How about we just marvel at both of them? You call a deep pass like that again on the next play, it could go to the end zone. But this time, it is a takeaway. Well, he was supposed to be the one who chipped away a few. He got a new set of downs started right in rhythm. Instead, he's now forced to pick himself from behind the line thanks to a great effort defensively.
And they get there to take him down right around the 41.
Kate, if there was one throw in the game plan that kept me up at night more than any other, it was an out route versus zone coverage. Because you got to throw with anticipation, but you also got to make sure those defenders' eyes aren't reading you like a book.
Pass taken in by St. Brown. And he's going to be taken down a yard shy of the... The end result there, 15 yards and a first. This is Montgomery. Give him about 16 yards on that gain, Brock, and it sets him up with first and goal. From the red zone now. Flush out, and they get to him as he was trying to make something happen. And the pressure drives them backwards.
And right there's the danger, Kate, when you put the ball in the air. How many times do we see these coordinators, when you get a nice run, right, you gain some steam on the ground, you stick with the ground game. They don't, they call the pass, and the defense. And reacts well with a sack.
Another try following the sack. He brings it in. And they bring him down at the 7-yard. They've held him out twice. Here we go, third and goal. That's the end of one. We're all set to bring you the second quarter. Lions well within striking distance. On third and goal, Goff. And they will score. Touchdown, Detroit. The Lions parlay the interception into points. Bates now for the point after. That one split. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Fox now to kick this one away. Return starts from the 16. They track him down, but a nice return in the end there, Brock. He's up to the 38. Another drive coming up for this Dallas offensive unit. And we've seen both extremes of this passing game so far, Brock. One touchdown and one interception on the ledger.
A home run and a strikeout. A little sampling of what works and what doesn't against this defense. Kate, now, gotta try to emphasize those things that you found success on with that opening drive.
Running the counter, Elliott. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
What was supposed to move the chains or at least make third down easier to handle instead? Well, did the exact opposite here, Kate. Now makes this third down a whole lot trickier to figure out.
Prescott now on third down. Made the throw as he was getting hit, Brock, and it's incomplete. Cowboys punting it away here on fourth, and it's the longtime vet Brian Anger on now. That hits at the 9, but nobody around to grab it. It carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Lions, then running back David Montgomery, getting back to work. They'll get this drive started, 1st and 10. And that lead they've got, Brock, they are never going to have to worry about losing it if they keep scoring every time they touch this football.
Is that how it works?
It surprisingly is. You know, if you have the lead and you don't lose it, you win.
That type of start? Well, you wanted all 17 games of a season, but you're lucky to get it more than once.
A jolt to start that drive. They're up near the 45-yard line. Goff on first and 10. This is complete. The ball's out. The ball's out. He lost it. And the fumble recovery is made. And they stop him before he gets much on the return.
Yeah, this just can't happen.
While a new offense preps to head out, we've got a stoppage. They want to make sure this is a turn. Play is under review. So the nice defensive play, all for naught. He was down first, no fumble. Running on second with Montgomery. And he's tackled with the first down yardage.
That's certainly a spot where you could be more aggressive, Kate, if you wanted to take your shots. And some coaches, even the bolder ones, will take the safe play first when they get it from time to time.
And down he goes. The Cowboy defense gets it to him. All right, here we go. Second down.
Sports. It's in the game.
Welcome back to all of you joining us for this one. We'll pick up the action back in the second quarter. Offense to the line for second down. Shotgun snap here to go. Patrick with the catch. And he's able to reach the 40 on that play. Third and 10. Can this offense get it done? From the gun, Goff. And down he goes. The Cowboy defense gets it to him. And the defense comes through to back them up ahead of fourth down.
Kate, I've seen a one-step drop. I've seen a 3, a 5, a 7. Some of the boots and play actions get more depth. But a 20-step drop? That's not going to cut it. Except for this defense, it just adds a whole bunch of negative yards to that play.
Fair catch made a little beyond the 20-yard line. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10. The Cowboys offense now headed back to the field. First down, here's Dak. Escapes the pocket. He's on the move.
You know, Kate, they always say that QB clock. You know what it's more like? It's more like an alarm. Especially in a situation like that, and it's a good thing he woke up to it, able to make something out of nothing and at least keep him moving forward.
And nothing doing on that run. Defenders bottle it up quickly. Third and a lone yard coming up. Here's Prescott. That's caught for the first. And he's going to be brought down at the 42. Drive picks up here, first and 10. Give to Elliott on the draw. And they're able to grind him to a halt after a pickup of 4. Second and 6 coming up here.
A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
Dak off the play fake. Ooh, would have been a big gainer if they connected, but they could not. Instead, third down coming up. From the gun is Prescott. Caught by the open man. And he's going to be drugged down, looks like, at that 37-yard line. A new set of downs awaits him. Here's first and 10.
That's good for a Cowboy.
They run it from the gun with Elliott. And he's just spinning his wheels, man, this entire first half. They drop him behind the line.
He was taken down.
Well, he was supposed to be the one who chipped away a few and got a new set of downs started right in rhythm. Instead, he's now forced to pick himself from behind the line thanks to a great effort defensively.
Got a man over the middle, complete. And they haul him down just a foot or two shy of the red zone. All set up now for first and 10.
First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Prescott here from the gun. Oh, what a grab. We're to the two-minute warning from AT&T. The Cowboys at a deficit.
At the 12-yard line.
In a good spot here, second and inches.
Yeah, here we go. Where did I check?
Working out of the gun, it's Prescott. Quick hitter, complete. He's brought down a little short. No, actually they do give him the 10-yard line. 1 yard gain on the play, and it'll be first down, Dallas. Dak throwing again. That throw behind his intended target.
Defense doubled him, knowing that was where the pass was likely headed. A bit surprising, quarterback still threw in that direction with how well that defense had that play covered.
The throw is caught. And not much doing, he stopped quickly. And the Lions into a nickel set for third down. Another throw for Prescott. And he will score. Touchdown, Dallas. The Cowboys earn the chance to tie before halftime. That one right down the middle. And we're all knotted up. Aubrey now to kick this one away. His return starts at the 5. And this drive will start inside the 25. Running back David Montgomery getting back to work. And we're a shade away from 50 seconds to go in the half. That's enough time to put something together. And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot. Markers reset, ball at the 37. On first down, it's gone. That's to the sideline, it's a catch by Williams. A 19-yard pickup, and that's gonna move the chains.
That is what elite offenses are all about. Why worry about three downs when you need only one? Move the chains in one play, and keep driving that defense backwards.
And he's taken down at the 30. Now the Lions calling a timeout. They're first. First and 10 now from the 30. Throwing again. It's gone. Rifles it, and it's caught. And they can't bring him down until he gets into that red zone at the 19. Timeout called by the offense. And with another timeout available, they could actually get another two plays if they were quick. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that's going to break our tie and give them a three-point advantage.
I never saw a play script that ended with a field goal. It was always a touchdown that you wanted. But that's 3 points, and it's enough to give them the lead.
Well, Brock, barring the touchback, this kickoff should run out the half, so better make that return good as it's away. And he'll take it up to the 30 before being brought down. That brings us to the break, and it's the visiting Lions holding an early advantage. Now we'll send you east to... In the interest of time, we'll bypass the halftime break and resume play with the third quarter. Aubrey now to kick this one away. starting from the 5. And pretty solid field position starting out here, Brock. He's tackled at the 29. Out come the Lions. They've got the first series of the second half. And their last drive did end in points. Not as many as they wanted, though. They had to settle for that field goal despite advancing the football pretty well. First down throw from Goff. This is complete to Gibbs. And he's downed after getting this up to the 41. They'll move the chains after that pickup of 12. First and 10 from the 41. Out of the shotgun, Goff. Short pass caught by his tight end. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. Tough play, Montgomery. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
Kid, I'll never forget walking into the Hall of Famer Dwight Freeney's meeting room with those defensive linemen. The late, great John Teerlink, his coach, he had a little sign up in his office, and it was sacks, and that money sign was the S, because ends and D linemen make their money with sacks. But you win games when they stop the run like that for a tackle for loss.
All plays on the table here for 3rd and 3. Goff back to throw. Connects with Montgomery.
I gotta be honest, it hurts a little extra when it comes on 3rd down, but it really doesn't matter what down it is. If a completed pass is stopped at the line of scrimmage offensively, that's a failure. Defensively, that's a success.
Looking to throw. And he has it down officially to the red zone at the 20. They went for it and got the 4 yards they needed, and that keeps this drive alive. On first down, they'll run with Montgomery. He picks up 15 on the play. And that gives them 1st and goal. He's been a fixture for them all game, and all signs indicate, Brock, he's going to remain one in the time we've got left.
Yeah, they've leaned on him in certain spots, and he has shouldered the load oh so well. Put together a game that everyone's happy with.
And he will get this to the end zone for a Detroit touchdown. The Lions grow the lead coming out of halftime. David Montgomery with the touchdown. That one splits the uprights, and they'll continue adding to their lead. Fox now to kick this one away. And this one doesn't make it into the landing zone. It comes down shy of the 20, and by the new rules this year, that means the ball is going to be placed at the 40-yard line. And this drive is going to have some great starting field position as a result of that short kick. Throwing on first is Prescott. Throw complete to Lamb. Jukes one defender, and he'll go out of bounds close to that 35-yard line. Markers reset, ball at the 37.
Good for our Cowboys. First and 10,
Prescott. Got Lamb, and it's complete. And this is down to the 28 before the defense holds it. Nice spot here for the offense. It's 2nd and 1. From the 28. Brought in by Elliott. And they get this down to the 12-yard line before being stopped. And big play at some 17 yards. And that's good for a Cowboys first down. Working inside the red zone. A lot of players around this one, and it is intercepted. Terrion Arnold has it. Inside the red zone, they could feel how tight they were to the goal line. And then, bam, Brock, they're off the field after a a clutch interception.
I tell you what, football's the ultimate team game, but this is a situation where an individual picks up all 10 of his guys out there on the field. Mm-hmm. Somebody else is going to pick up the tab at dinner tonight for him.
Goff on first and 10. Short pass caught by his tight end. And this one only gets up to about the 5-yard line.
He's just one of those guys. Not open, he's still a target thanks to that physicality and his ability to just play bully ball. They don't like forcing into coverage, but sometimes when you got a bully like him that can create space, you just find a way to get him the ball.
And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. They manage 22 on the rip and a first down.
I think my favorite part was the magic he worked after the catch. The way he took the completion and made so much more out of it by adding all the extra yardage.
Shotgun snap here to Goff. St. Brown there to bring it in. And he'll get it up near the 38-yard line before going down. This game has already been a good one for him, Brock. And hey, there's still time. He could add on even more.
And you just feel his aggressive mindset all game long. As long as there's time left, he's going to want to keep on firing and turn a good performance into a great one.
Montgomery now up the middle. And he drives ahead for good yardage up to the 45. Pickup of 8 on the run. And that sets up 2nd and 2.
So much to like about that run, Kate, particularly what he was able to get out of it. The defense, I think, feels a little fortunate they were able to track him down before an even bigger run and crossing that first down marker.
And he made a bid for midfield there, but stopped on his own side at the 49. From the gun, Goff. And he's going to be brought down after reaching the 43. After a good pickup, they're set up with 2nd and short. First game on the ground to Jahmyr Gibbs. And he takes it just inside the 40, down to the 39. It's a gain of 4. And that gives the Lions the first.
I don't know about you, Kate, but he sure made getting that first down look really easy. A lot easier than it's supposed to be for that defense. And I think they'll hear about it when they get to the sidelines.
First down now, ball at the 39-yard line. Now gone. To the right and hauled in by Laporta. And they get this down to the 28. It's a gain of 12 there. And that'll be first down, Detroit. Looking to throw, Goff. This one delivered off target, Brock. That's incomplete. First time this game they've looked to him. And we'll see what they do here on 2nd down. They send St. Brown in motion left. Off play action, Goff. Buying some time right. He's gonna keep it this time. And he gets this forward to the 19. We'll see what they come up with for 3rd down in just a bit. We've reached the end of 3. It's Lions ball as they try to keep that lead and close out a win. Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 2. Here's Goff. And it's incomplete, and that's going to bring up 4th down.
Well covered on that play. Really not a large window for him to sneak that throw in.
And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that pushes the lead up to 13.
Those 3 points could go a long way to securing this W. Makes it a lot more comfortable knowing the other side's got to score a couple touchdowns now. A touchdown to field goals, not going to get it done anymore.
The return manages to get just beyond the 30. The Cowboys offense headed out there. And a nice drive last time out, Brock, squandered by that interception. So I think they'd take a repeat of everything except that final play. Quick hitter complete. And he's short of the first after a mild gain. Halfway to the marker, it's second and five.
At the 37-yard line.
From the 37. No hesitation, and that one's caught. And he's tackled with the first down yardage.
I'm sure coach and play caller doesn't mind making the job a little bit easier. You know, play calling's a lot simpler and easier when you count on the offense to move the chains on those early downs.
That's incomplete left side. Defender smart there to get a hand on that one. And now they face second down.
I'm just going to say, maybe not the guy you want to pick on in coverage on this particular series. Gets a hand on that throw and knocks it away. The next time, well, he could get two hands on it and take it the other way.
Another throw for Prescott. Oh, he put some heat on this deep. That's cut at the 25. They'll get 31 yards on the play. And it'll be first down, Dallas.
You know, Kent, we often talk about flipping the field in special teams, right? A kick return, a good punt. Well, an explosive play like that does the exact same thing. Look at the difference in field position. By hitting on that shot, you've totally flipped the field and the tone of this drive.
Sets him up nice and pretty at the 25 following that big play. Dak throwing again. Oh, brother, it's another interception. Terrion Arnold has it.
Intercepted by the Lions. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
And the drive will start out with a first and 10. Off to the air now. He had it for a moment, but a great defensive play to jar it loose. Incomplete. No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Gibbs now from the gun. And they'll stand him up and sit him down at the line. No gain on the play, and they still need 10 now on third down.
Stopped right at the line, but might as well have been a loss of yards as far as the offense is concerned. It's always humbling when you try force versus force, and the defense wins out.
This drive in jeopardy. Here's a third and 10. Gone. Cowboys rushing in and they bring him down. And the defense comes through. That's going to back him up and bring up fourth down. The Lions readying for the punt. Punt taken near midfield. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. Call that a punt of 47 yards. And the Cowboys will take over with some excellent field position. Here's Prescott, first and 10. He'll dump this one off to his running back, complete. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. And he will score, touchdown, Dallas! The Cowboys now within one score in the fourth. That one right down the middle. And they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. So here's the kickoff, Brock. Just 6 points now separating our teams. This return starts at the five. He's got a lane up past the 30. And he gets across the 30 before he's brought down. Now the Lions offense gets ready to return to the field. And this really looks like a whole different ball game after that touchdown, doesn't it? They really need to go on a drive here. And they try to power it forward, but only a couple of yards there.
They got some positive yards. That's a good thing. But too many plays like that, it just is too hard to pile together, get first downs, gets the better defenses in this league.
Running on second with Montgomery. Across the 45 and still going. And he's going to get all the way up to the midfield stripe. Well, this certainly has been a memorable contest for him, his coaches. Man, they're going to take this kind of output every single game.
This goes a little beyond the expectations they have for him, maybe even for himself. What impresses me so much, Kate, the guy just doesn't tire, getting stronger, literally, as this game's going on.
They'll come up first and 10. We've reached the two-minute warning from Dallas. Lions leading by six. They have themselves another first and 10. They'll run again with Montgomery. And he'll cross the 50 and start pushing onto the opposing side of the field. So quickly, the defense burns a timeout here. 1:57 remaining in the game. Second and 6 coming up here. On the ground with Montgomery and just gets back to the line of scrimmage. With 1:54 remaining, the defense burns a timeout. Let's see what they draw up on this 3rd and 7. He'll throw it. Rifles it and it's caught. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains. The defense takes its 3rd and final timeout. New slate of downs to approach here from the 40. A give up the gut to Montgomery. And he's only able to power this forward for about 3 yards. Second down now, 7 to go. And they'll let the clock run all the way down and expire. Must have lost sight of the play clock there, Brock, because the quarterback could have snapped it in time, but instead, they take the penalty. Everyone's prepped. It's second down now. Running it after the penalty. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. All right, Cowboys showing Nichols at 3rd down. They're just going to let the clock run out and take this delay.
Delay of game.
Everyone was set and at the line. The quarterback just didn't snap it before the play clock hit 0.
Still 3rd down.
Setting up for the kneel down on 3rd. And he's going to take a knee.
Nothing left to do now, Kate, but celebrate on one side and watch on hopelessly from the other. What a hard-fought effort to get to this spot, and now you can enjoy the victory.
So the Lions get the win on the road. And they're off to a good start in the preseason, Brock. Seen a lot of players fighting together for the victory. So for Brock Heward, our incredible crew, everybody here at EA Sports, I'm Kate Scott signing off. We'll see you next time.